Okay, bro. So very quickly, let's get on to our next match. That is Bayern versus Chelsea. Bayern already thumbed Chelsea at the bridge 3-0. Gnabry ran that show, and Chelsea would be coming to Allianz Arena hoping that they could cause an upset. What do you think?
I think Lampard won't be too frustrated by the fact if they lose to Bayern, which I think they will. I don't think Lampard will be too fazed by that fact, because he probably knows himself that his team is not experienced enough to take on the big guns, the biggest of the UCL. Yeah. So even if they do lose, they'll go home knowing the fact that they put on a show. They posed a competition to the biggest threat in the UCL.
They just want to go out. They just want to go out and prove to the world. Prove to the likes of Manchester United, Spurs, and even City that, and even Liverpool that, yes, they can do what the other teams fail to do in this year's Champions League.
Yeah, yeah, pretty much.
Because Liverpool got knocked out, and it's upon
United's not there. Liverpool got knocked out.
I'm actually happy. I don't know why, but it feels so good that Liverpool got knocked out. I mean, no disrespect again.
No offense
again
to Liverpool fans.
they'll be cursing me.
Yeah, actually, you know, the players got slightly arrogant. You see their posts and stuff.
You are very right about this fact that they got arrogant and they got a bit of a tone. But
yeah, pretty much. It was like they expected to win. They were the favorites. They expected to win another UCL.
Because bro, they are not used to winning. They have won like first title in 30 years, and we do it every freaking year. So we know how to be modest. We know how to be cool with the UEFA Champions League.
We don't parade it around. We'll never say you don't walk. You never walk alone.
Yeah, fine. All right,
that's
fine. So Bayern, Spurs 7-2, and what a performance they have had all season. I mean, Bayern ran the show in Bundesliga, and Lewandowski. I just put up a video about discussing that Lewa was robbed of this Ballon d'Or, and few of my friends were there on the video, and they were like, they were upset because they thought that Lewa is gonna win it, and he probably had the best case out of all the people, out of all the players this year.
Yeah, exactly. The impact he has had on Bayern, like, even if not for the goals, the chances created, it's, you know, once an opponent knows that you're capable of creating so many chances in a game, so many scoring chances, scoring so many times, they will get slightly on the down. Their mindset won't be as high as they were when they came into the game.
Yeah.
So that, just take a few numbers if you may. 34 goals in Bundesliga, top scorer in the league, top scorer in Europe, 11 goals in UCL, top scorer there.
Immobile will be beating him, bro.
Immobile will be, he has two more games at the same number of goals.
And
still, 34 is not a small number.
Bayern fans will be worried that they'll be sitting holding head in hands, and they'll be like, no, don't score. Don't fucking score, Immobile.
Golden boot.
okay, you know who you are.
You take Bayern's form in the Bundesliga, they've scored 100 league goals.
100 league goals, shit.
100 league goals in 34 games, which is huge. And they've scored and they've conceded 32 league goals, which is the least in the league.
And it accounts to how many goals per game?
More than around 3.
3, yeah.
3 goals a game, like you go into a game and the opponent knows you'll score 3 a game, minimum. Shit.
So, Chelsea fans, be ready for some demolition. I don't say that Bayern is going to demolish you all, but I want Lampard to put up a show that they give some kind of competition to Bayern, because they cannot beat Bayern. They've got 3 away goals, man. 3 away goals.
Yeah. And the most important thing for Lampard will be the European competition, giving a feel of it to his to the youngsters. More than the win. I'm pretty sure they won't be looking for the win. Everyone knows it's slightly unrealistic expectations from them. Considering you take Bayern's team, you take Gnabry, it's not just Lewandowski in that team.
Yeah, actually.
You take Gnabry, you take Coutinho, you take Müller. Perisic. Has 29 goals plus assists this season.
Shit. And Perisic, just not forget the defense. Alphonso Davies. Don't forget Davies.
Insane. Look, once you get caught napping, he takes advantage. He can single-handedly run through the entire length of the pitch.
I can imagine. I can see Alphonso Davies running at Azpilicueta down on the left side, or Reece James. They won't be able to catch him.
They'll be spun around pretty much. I can't find a better word to say.
So, Kimmich is there.
One thing, Süle is coming back.
Boarding also doing fine. And Lucas Hernandez.
Alaba is there. They have multiple. One is a treble motivation.
Yes.
Then the other thing is Lewandowski, as you said, might be overtaken by Immobile.
Hmm.
So one thing he can compete for now that proves conclusively that he's one of the if not the best player in Europe this season, will be the FIFA the best.
If not, bro, it doesn't matter if he's awarded something or not. We'll remember this year for Lewandowski. We'll remember what he has caused this year. So quick prediction about this match for you.
I think it'll be another 3-0.
3-0. Why we are so asphyxiated on that number 3? Chelsea fans, shit.
Because of the defense and Mr. Kepa.
Kepa, oh. Okay. Lampard, I don't think so that he trusts his keeper. The world's most expensive keeper. So, I don't think so. He's losing his spot.
It's pretty much because you take the Premier League stats for Kepa. I don't remember after the lockdown, but before that, he had a 50% save percentage. Shit. Which is not what you want from the world's costliest keeper.
We shouldn't be making fun of him. Actually, he was pretty good at Athletic. Actually, one of the reasons that Chelsea has been leaking goals is also because of their poor defense. I don't think so that defense is Coach Zuma and Rudiger. I don't think so that
Rudiger
they are in a good connection.
Up to the mark.
Because Lampard has been spending left and right for Hakim Ziyech, Timo Werner, and now most recently Kai Havertz. So what Lampard should be doing is getting a centre back. Get a centre back, get a left back. Ben Chilwell is the best replacement because Marcus Alonso on that left, he's not good. He's not good anymore because right side we have the cover of Reece James, but at left, I don't think so. Marcus Alonso or Emerson, they both are not at the level of Chelsea because if Frank Lampard wants to set up a team which can compete at the best levels of Premier League and even the Champions League because now they have qualified for the Champions League, so they will need to have the best in the attack and also in the defense.
If not the best, at least showing heavy promise.
Definitely. And because Ben Chilwell and probably a good centre half would do.
Yeah, Ben Chilwell and Onana seems to be having talks with Chelsea.
Yes, actually, I think so that Ajax are demanding 30 million for Onana. He's a good keeper. So let's not get sidetracked. We were talking about Bayern and Chelsea, were we, in 1970s? So let's come back.
3-0, yeah, I told that 3-0 number.
So you said 3-0, yeah. I'll go for 2-0 Bayern because I don't want to be so hard on Chelsea. So 2-0 for me. Okay, let's quickly move on to our next game. That is going to be Juventus versus Lyon. And Lyon recorded a win at home, 1-0. And Lucas Tozard was the scorer for that match. And when Juventus will be facing Lyon at home, what do you expect?